In this video, I'm going to share with you 10 top tips to combat MS fatigue. Don't turn away because that starts right now. Howdy! Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between visits, and it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. Today's topic is a big one, MS fatigue. Fatigue is the most common symptom in MS across all phenotypes and age groups. It's also one of the leading causes of loss of work. It's an invisible symptom, which is super frustrating. You've heard this before.
Honey, you look so good. Oh, you don't look tired.
In order to help someone else understand MS fatigue, I oftentimes share the following analogy. Imagine that you went to work on Monday and didn't sleep Monday night. Then you went to work on Tuesday and didn't sleep Tuesday night. On Wednesday, you and I will go for a walk and have a conversation. And that's as close as I've been able to get to help a spouse or a loved one understand what someone with MS impacted by fatigue might be experiencing. In this video, I'm going to share with you 10 top tips to combat fatigue. And if you stick around to the end, I'll throw in an 11th tip just for good measure. So let's get started. Tip number one is to treat multiple sclerosis. Taking a disease-modifying therapy to slow MS down also improves fatigue. This has been shown with almost every single DMT when you look at clinical trials. And it's my belief that the more effective medicines have a larger impact on fatigue. Tip number two is to treat depression. People with MS are twice as likely to experience depression as compared to the general population. One of the common associated symptoms with depression is fatigue. And it's been my experience in clinic that when we tackle depression, we improve fatigue. Now, I have several videos on this channel dedicated to beating up on depression. And so I'll make sure to throw a card up above and a link in the description down below in case you want to check some of those out. Tip number three is to address disordered sleep. If you're getting up 5 times a night to pee, or if you're having spasms that wake you from sleep, or if you have restless leg syndrome, or if you have trouble initiating or staying asleep because of insomnia, or if you have obstructive sleep apnea, the quality of your sleep takes a hit, and it makes perfect sense that you're going to be more tired the next day. We have to pay really close attention to sleep quality and quantity if we're going to improve energy levels. That's an important one, guys. Tip number four, treat heat sensitivity. Many people with MS find that when their body gets overheated, either because they've been exercising or because it's hot outside, their energy goes to almost nothing. And we need to be proactive in trying to combat that. I have a playlist on this channel where I talk about temperature-related symptoms, so I'll make sure to include a link up above and down in the description below. But paying attention to heat sensitivity and doing things to combat it, whether that be taking a pill for heat sensitivity or wearing a cooling vest when you go outside, can have a positive impact in improving energy levels. Tip number five is to combat spasticity. Spasticity occurs in upwards of 70% of people with MS. It causes painful Charlie horses and cramps, spasms where legs and arms bounce. It also causes limbs that are hard to bend. And when you're trying to walk with limbs that are hard to bend, you're expending all kinds of extra energy just to get the job done. If we appropriately treat your spasticity, it makes moving easier, you save energy while moving, and it can help energy levels. Tip number six is a really big one. Address polypharmacy. Doctors are pretty good about prescribing new medicines. We're not so good at removing medicines. And the average MS patient in the United States is on 7 medicines. That's a lot. And oftentimes, medicines can cause side effects of sedation. Pain medicines, neuropathic pain medicines, spasticity medicines, antidepressants, sleep aids. There's a multitude of medicines that we commonly prescribe in MS that can have a side effect of sedation. I encourage you to take your med list to your practitioner and say, hey, is there anything on here that we can pull off or decrease the dose to see if by removing them, I gain some more energy. Tip number seven is to address cardiovascular risk factors. I'm talking about diabetes, morbid obesity, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, inactivity, and smoking cigarettes. Controlling cardiovascular risk factors improves energy levels. It also slows down multiple sclerosis progression. So there's innumerate reasons why that's a really good idea. But in this video, I'm focusing on the fact that people that control their cardiovascular risk factors invariably have more energy, and you can too. Number 8, if you have a low vitamin D, a low vitamin B12, if you have a low thyroid, or if you're a man with low testosterone, you're gonna be tired. And so checking laboratories to identify those things and supplementing to make those levels normal can do wonders for improving your energy levels. Number 9, diet. This is one that I've only recently started to pay increasing attention to. And I believe that by altering your diet, it can have a massive impact on your energy levels. And if you don't believe me, I challenge you to try it out. Step 1 is to increase your water intake. I've got lots of videos on how to do that on this channel, so links up above and down below if you want to check that out. I'm also a strong believer that avoiding sugar and processed foods can do wonders for your energy levels. So if you haven't tried altering your diet, take a crack at it and you may find your energy levels soar. Number 10, exercise. This sounds paradoxical. You might say, Dr. B, I'm so exhausted, there's no way I can exercise. But if you approach it very slowly and very slowly, incrementally increase what you can do, you can actually grow your functional reserve. And people that exercise as part of their lifestyle have way more energy and they sleep better than people that don't. You might need to work with a physical therapist or with your provider to find the right type of exercise for you, but if you're suffering from fatigue, this is a secret weapon to make things better. You made it to the end of this quick little video, and I promised you a bonus tip. And the bonus tip is medicines. There are a host of medicines that we can use to trick the brain into being more awake. And I want to encourage you to talk to your provider about whether any of these medicines might be appropriate for you. These are things like Provigil, Nuvigil, Adderall, and even amino acids like levocarnitine. I'm not telling you to go out and take them. I'm telling you that as a bonus tip, talk to your doc and see if it makes sense to try them out. My name is Aaron Boster, and I want to thank you for learning about MS with me. If you'd like to hear more about fatigue, check out this playlist right there. YouTube thinks that you would adore this video right there. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please consider doing so. Just click the circle right over there. Until my next video or live stream, this is Aaron Boster saying take care.